Well, I'm sure many of you will have sat and suffered listening to the cup draw, waiting for your team to come out of the velvet bag at Lancaster Gate. They're agonising moments, and you can see that managers suffer as much as anyone. We were with John Bond of Manchester City and Keith Birkinshaw of Spurs when this evening's draw was made.
Number 17, Ipswich Town. Number 2, against Aston Villa.
Oh, what a game.
Number 22.
That's us.
Manchester City.
Tottenham.
Number 13. No. Against Crystal Palace.
What do you think about that?
Malcolm.
Number 32.
Did he do that, do you think?
Queen's Park Rangers.
Number 39.
Against Tottenham Hotspur.
Doing battle with Terry Venables.
Yes, but it's. I think you can forget about managers. You know, I think there's too much said about what managers are going to do in these sort of games. It's about the players at the end of the day, and we must have a fair chance there.
Now, Malcolm said some pretty unkind things about you a fortnight ago on this programme. I mean, have you had any conversations with him since then?
Yeah, I've spoken to him on the phone, and he said, if we can't criticise each other and have little chats, he says, and be mates together, he said, what's the world coming to? I said, lovely. I mean, as I said all the way along, that didn't really bother me. If Keith here had said the things that Malcolm said about me, that hurt me a lot more than if Malcolm had said. I mean, I don't bother. It don't bother me if Malcolm says them. I mean, I've taken them since about 1954 and I'm trying to keep taking them.
In those old West Ham days.
Well, that's right.
But a game you look forward to, no?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Home draw is all you can expect, as I said.
Well, that ties the talking point of the third round, and Malcolm Allison was apparently visibly shaken when he heard about it in the Palace press room. But he says he knows what to expect of the City players. Meantime, at Luton, referee Mike Bidmead was knocked out unintentionally, I should stress, when he was hit on the side of the head by a clearance from Luton defender Mark Azlewood. Both trainers came to his rescue. The match was held up for a couple of minutes, but he recovered and saw Luton beat Preston 4-2. And Lil Fuschillo scored for Luton in his comeback. Two broken legs have kept him out for two seasons. Sadly, there are reports of crowd trouble today. Barriers collapsed at Tranmere and at Wimbledon, where fans spilled onto the pitch in an incident sparked off by the players. Wimbledon and Swindon players scuffling in the goalmouth. The fans surged forward and the barrier gave way. But no one was seriously hurt and the match finished 2-0 to Wimbledon. And there's news tonight that Nottingham Forest are preparing a bid for European players. While Forest were losing at Leeds today, both Brian Clough and Peter Taylor were in Germany to watch Bayern Munich. They saw two players have an outstanding match. They were Einar Ørst, the Norwegian international defender who once interested Arsenal, and Kurt Niedermeyer, a 25-year-old central defender. He won his first cap for West Germany against Holland a few weeks back. Peter Taylor describes the trip as fruitful and says he expects further developments. And tomorrow he's due in Holland to watch, as I understand it, Ajax.